It's cold outside, but the fire keeps us warm. We can spend the night underneath the mistletoe. And I've gotten you a present that I put under the tree. Tomorrow it is Christmas, the first for you and me.
Hi, I'm Rachel and welcome back to my channel. So this is my top 10 Christmas film. There is going to be a lot of people's different opinions about which film should be in here and which film shouldn't be in, but I do have a certain like top 10 ranking, and these are my top 10 Christmas films for 2020. But please let me know which your top three are down below in the comments. I would love to know. And there may be a Christmas film which I've never watched and it may be your favourite, and then it gets me to find a new Christmas film which I could watch. Let's get straight into it. So, at number 10 is a film which came out in 2018 on Netflix, and it's directed by Bradley Walsh, and that is The Holiday Calendar. So this is a film where you'll meet Abby. Abby is a photographer, and she wants more than in life than just taking photos of children sat on Santa's knee. She inherits of her grandfather an advent calendar, and she's like, really? This is just a boring wooden advent calendar. Why would you want to give me that? However, on the December the 1st, it opens magically and reveals something. And then she starts believing in the magic, because these items will open. For instance, it'll open on the 1st and there is a pair of boots. And she's like, okay. Then within the 1st of December, her best friend buys her a pair of boots, and she starts believing that this advent calendar is magical. So throughout the advent calendar, you relive the magic of what Christmas is, and then Abby starts to fall for a man, and then there's a bit of Christmas romance, but there is a twist to the romance. And does she find her dream way of opening her own photography shop? Who knows? But it's such a sweet film, not a lot of characters in it, and I love the magic of an advent calendar because it just brings back moments when I had an advent calendar as a young child. I still do have an advent calendar, but really being excited to open up the first of the calendar, especially the first, and seeing what piece of chocolate I've got and what it's going to be shaped as and what the joke is. I absolutely loved the magic of an advent calendar, and having chocolate in the morning, it was just, that was not what you had, but on Christmas, the run up to Christmas, you had a piece of chocolate in the morning. So that's why I absolutely love this film. Number 9. Now this will shock a lot of people because I know it's a lot of people's firm favourite, and that is The Polar Express. Now don't get me wrong, The Polar Express is absolutely magical. It's got Tom Hanks in as the train conductor, and it's about a boy who doesn't believe in the magic, and he gets a ticket for The Polar Express and he goes on an adventure, and I just love it. I love the magic. However, why it's not any higher up is I only love watching this film on Christmas Eve. This is my Christmas Eve film. I never watch it any other time apart from Christmas Eve. So for that reason, it's magical in itself and I love the story, but I only watch it once throughout the Christmas period. And for me, it's just my Christmas Eve film, which I love having with a hot chocolate. I love watching to it. It's only magical for me on Christmas Eve, and I think that's because I used to watch it as a kid on Christmas Eve only, and it's something which I still do to this day. Number 8 is the classic Holiday with Jude Law in it, Cameron Diaz, Kate Winslet. It is a lovely film. I adore it. Two girls who basically swap houses decide to, they're really unhappy, they are fed up of being on their own at Christmas, they've got a lot going on, so they swap houses and they meet different people on their journeys, and they realise that there is magic in Christmas, and it's such a lovely story, lovely and cliche and a rom-com, and I adore it. And Jude Law in this is lovely, and when he does Nat King Man, I just love it. It's just an all-round good film. Number 7 is The Christmas Chronicles. I adore this. This is on Netflix. What an amazing series this is. And number 2 is just out. I'm recording this before I've seen number 2. So I am just classing The Christmas Chronicles all together. I love watching this film. It is lovely. So The Christmas Chronicles is about a brother and a sister. The brother doesn't believe in the magic whatsoever now, but the sister does. They have loved Christmas as a family, and then their dad dies and the magic is just not there anymore, and the mum is desperate to bring the magic back, and he's going on the wrong path. And the sister finds out that she's going on the wrong path and makes a pact that to do an all-nighter and to capture Father Christmas. Now, on the night, there is an accident with Father Christmas and his sleigh, and both of them go on a journey with the straight-talking Father Christmas to save Christmas. And Santa in this is not your usual Santa, what you think of, and I just love it. It's a different spin on a Christmas story, and the characters in it are lovely, and I cannot wait to see number 2. I know I'm pre-recording this early, but we'll just class them all as number 7. So at number 6, it is The Christmas Drop-Off. This is found on Netflix. I have watched this film so many times. Now, the story is based on a true story itself, and knowing that going into this, it makes the story a lot different. Obviously, this is a romantic comedy, but the actual Operation Drop-Off is true. So this is about Erica. Erica has been asked by her boss to go to the Air Force base to try and close it down, to give her boss a reason to close it down, because they need to save money. So Erica goes, and she is one of these people who does things by the book. However, she hasn't met Captain Andrew, or as everyone calls him, Claus. So Captain Andrew is a lovely family guy, hasn't been at Christmas with his family for many, many years. He believes that everyone should have a little bit of Christmas magic in them. So he has this Operation Drop-Off where the islanders get together, and they'll make big boxes full of crayons, to paper, to rice, to blankets and stuff, and the boxes then get dropped off through the Air Force, and they land with the parachutes, and everything what is dropped off is used. So the parachutes are used as sails, the boxes are used as firewood, and then also inside there is school supplies for the children, and it's absolutely lovely what this Operation Drop-Off does, and it still goes to this day. But then Erica finds a soft spot for Andrew and realises that what they are doing is amazing and shouldn't be defunded, because there is no, everything's done for the community of it, and nothing comes out of the taxpayers' money. It's all done by favours and just being kind to one another. The story is amazing. Captain Andrew is very nice indeed, and there may be a little bit of romance there, but overall the story itself is lovely and I highly recommend it. So number 5 is The Nativity. I am just talking about the first one. The first one to me is the best one in my personal opinion. I love this because it's a really good take on a children's nativity play set in a school. So this is about Mr. Madams, who is a primary school teacher, and he had dreams of being an actor himself. However, he went into teaching. He has a teaching assistant called Mr. Poppet, and Mr. Poppet is a child at heart. And Mr. Madams has been given the task to produce the nativity itself. And Mr. Poppet goes overboard. He does auditions for children. Then he overhears a conversation about Hollywood and him knowing a Hollywood star, which Mr. Maddens has not told us about. And then the press get in and all this little nativity play then is heightened about this Hollywood star coming to the school. It's such a lovely little story and I just love it. I love how it's school children and remembering how much the nativity play meant, trying to get a main part like Mary, Joseph, one of the shepherds. It was just lovely and I absolutely love it. And Mr. Popper is just such an amazing teaching assistant and it's just what children need in a school. Number four is The Miracle on 34th Street. This is a classic. Everyone knows what this is about. This is about a little girl who lives with her mum. Her mum is high up in a toy department store. She doesn't believe in Christmas anymore, whereas the little girl is begging to believe in the magic. Her mum has a friend who is a lawyer who believes in the magic of Christmas, loves Christmas, and the mum and her friend go their separate ways. However, the mum of the department store needs a Santa and she finds Mr. Kris Kringle, who is just the best Santa whatsoever. However, unknown to them, this is the real deal. This is the real Santa. It's about how the other department store make out that Father Christmas is real and he is an evil guy because he's hurt another person. And it's a classic. I think everyone's watched this film and it rates highly in my top 10, that is for sure. Number three is a new one, and so far I have watched this too many times. I have downloaded the soundtrack for this movie. I watched it the first day it came out and I have raved about it on all my social medias. This is number three and this is Jingle Jangle. Wow. What an amazing film. If you like The Greatest Showman and all the musicals, and this is the Christmas film for you. This is amazing. The music itself is stunning. And this is not about Santa and his elves or anything like that. It's so much more. It's set at Christmas. I highly recommend anyone watching this film or even downloading the soundtrack first, because like The Greatest Showman, I listened to the soundtrack before I'd actually seen the film, and the music just comes alive when you watch the film. So this story is about Jonicus Jangle, who is a toy inventor, and all his creations are loved by children and adults alike. But he has to learn and love and invent again after his greatest creation is stolen by his apprentice. This is just where it starts. The songs, the storyline, it's obscured, it's funny, The apprentice is more like a panto villain in this, I feel. It's just very different and it's not about Santa and elves. This is about our magic, what we believe and belief in ourselves and our family and what's important. I highly recommend anyone watching. Out of all of them, watch this one. It'll be a classic film which a lot of people will watch every single year. So I think my daughter Grace, it'll be in her top five as she grows up. It's that good of a film. Gonna be like a classic, like Miracle on 34th Street kind of thing. It is incredible. So number two is The Grinch. I love The Grinch. This is especially the one where The Grinch is played by Jim Carrey. So this is the story based by Dr. Seuss. I love this. So The Grinch is this green, pot-bellied, mean character who absolutely despises Christmas. He's lived on a cliff on his own with his dog Max for 53 years. He hates the sound of Christmas, the Christmas carols, the joyness. He absolutely hates it. And they say that he hates it is because his heart is two sizes smaller than what it needs to be. And he overlooks Whoville, who absolutely adore Christmas. He thinks Christmas is, everyone's lost the spirit of what Christmas means, because he sees in his dumpster on Christmas Day, the toys which get chucked away. He thinks Christmas has lost the true meaning. He has this plan to steal Christmas, to take away all the Christmas stuff, the Christmas trees, the presents, and he successfully does it. However, he still hears the singing and the dancing, and he realises that Christmas may be more than just the presents and the Christmas tree. It's about who you spend it with. A funny character, and he makes you laugh about it, laugh as well. I do like the cartoon version. I do prefer the Jim Carrey one. It's the classic, and that one is my number two. So what is my favourite Christmas film of all time? And that is Kevin! That's right, it's Home Alone. But I've got to say, it's Home Alone 2, Lost in the City. For me, New York is just a magical place. It is the place of Christmas, in my personal opinion. And when he gets lost in the city, a city I absolutely adore and I've been to. And in March when I went, it had snowed. And even then in March, it was magical. So what will it be? Would it be in November, December time? Oh my goodness me, I bet it's amazing. So this is about Kevin, who his parents forget about him, let's say, and he ends up going to New York City instead of going on the family holiday with his parents. And he takes his dad's wallet and he goes to the Plaza Hotel and checks in. And obviously the two naughty burglars have just been released from prison, or the sticky bandits, I think they're called now. You're just waiting for the mayhem and the funniness to arrive. It's just a classic. Watch this film over and over again. Don't get me wrong, Home Alone 1 is incredible, but I think as it's set in New York and that extra magical buzz, got to be Home Alone 2, Lost in the City. So that's my top 10 Christmas films, and maybe Christmas films which are like, why haven't you mentioned this one? Christmas films, I adore all Christmas films, but if I had to put them in a ranking, these are my top 10. Please let me know what your top 3 are down below in the comments. I would love to find out what your top 3 are. And also, like I said earlier, I'd like to find more Christmas films to watch. So I hope you've enjoyed this. As always, sending huge positive thoughts. See you soon. Bye.